When dividing an estate, must each stock be divided individually, or can stocks be divided as a group? I'm wondering what to inform my children. Let's say okay. I have a Robinhood account, right? And I'm like, I have a bunch of different stocks, or maybe I have bonds and stuff. And like, cool. Like, let's say I've got, I don't know, like all sorts of different stuff, stuff that pays dividends, stuff that I have, like, I don't know, different, I don't know, what kind of different stocks are there? There's like IPOs, there's like, what about like, can't you like short stocks and stuff? Could I like pass someone on like my shorted stocks or something? Is that a thing?
Yes. So if a shorted position, you could, you would have to have a really good transition because you want to hold that short for committed to the long term.
Yeah, maybe it's like Tesla.
If you really hate a company and you're really to ride this thing out to the bottom.
Or maybe I think Tesla's overinflated and it's going to crash, but I have a terminal
illness.
You're
committed to it.
Yeah. 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 And in the meantime, I'm willing to pay a ton of money.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. So you can pass that on. So, okay, cool. That's super interesting. Now, let's say I have my Robinhood account. I want my Boeing stock to go to this person. I want my other stock to go to this person. Can I do that?
If you talk with your brokerage company, they're really going to be the ones who just drive this. Mm-hmm. But for the, you can, if you want that, I would explicitly state in a document that I want this stock to go to this person, this stock to go to that person, that stock to go to that person. You would probably constantly have to be updated as you change your stock.
Buy and sell stocks, yeah.
But if some people, I do have clients who've, their families own the same stock for 50 years. Like they own a big chunk of, I don't know, some insurance company or some tech company that their granddad started in the garage, and they may still own a share of it. Mm-hmm. And if that's the case, and like, I want this to go that makes more sense as a long-term plan.
Right.
But what happens in real life with most brokerage accounts, if it gets split two or three ways, they literally take the whole pot, cut it up evenly.
Okay.
So if there's like 100 shares of one stock, everyone gets 33 and a third share of it, and they just slice it apart in more or less equal shares of equal value. And the reason they usually split the shares up in addition is to ensure that the shares stay equal. So if you split stock A, B, and C that are equal at like 9 a.m. by 5 o'clock, to be worth different values. So it's easier to split all the shares into equal chunks of shares.
Huh.
So that no one can say that they got more or less, unless you tell them otherwise. Having said that, I'm really curious about what her reasoning is for caring.
Yeah,
There's probably a good reason I'm being difficult. But this is around time where I ask my clients in the weeds of like, will this keep you up at night if someone gets a different amount of the same stock?
Yeah, she did not explain, but I really
want to ask. I just want to know.
Are there any other like intangible assets like that you can pass on?
Yeah, most intangible assets get split that way. So like bank accounts, if you divide it out. Well, granted, that often passes through the estate or the trust in chunks. Brokerage accounts.
So what about something like a trademark or something? Like, could I pass on a trademark somebody?
Okay, so it depends on how it's held. So usually I would not recommend passing on a trademark, but I recommend forming the entity that owns a trademark and splitting ownership of it.
Okay.
I guess you could split revenue from the trademark or copyright if it's producing something.
Mm-hmm.
That's the point, though, where you're going to want to
speak to an estate planner.
Yeah, if you have a trademark or a copyright that's generating income, yeah, you want to talk with an attorney. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful or at least enjoyable, listening to us rip apart the great legal questions from the depths of the internet. It would help us out if you could like, share, or leave a comment below this video. Also, if you want to protect your family through the estate planning process, please give us a call. Our direct number is 404-738-9538. And you can also leave us an email at the address below.